Hello children, welcome back to ALPA Active Learning. Today's topic is letter writing, and you all know what is the importance of writing skill in an English language. Remember, this letter writing is a compulsory question of 5 marks. So before we begin, do like, share, comment my video. So what is a letter first? Letter is a written or printed communication directed to a person or an organization. So once you write this letter, the letter may be created and sent as email or by hand and courier services or by regular mail services. So this letter is of two types, formal एंड इनफॉर्मल, जिसे हम औपचारिक और अनौपचारिक पत्र हिंदी में कहते हैं. सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दिस टू एंड हाउ दिस लेटर्स आर रिटन. व्हेन आई से इनफॉर्मल लेटर, दिस लेटर इज रिटन टू आवर फैमिली मेंबर्स और फ्रेंड्स. That means your parents, your brother, your sister, your uncle, aunt, niece, nephew. So this is to the any family members and friends. Now on what different occasions you can write this? One is asking or giving permission. Second, asking for or giving opinion or suggestions. It can be accepting or declining or even giving the invitation or congratulating on achievements, that is motivating, and expressing condolences or apologizing. That means in our day-to-day life, whatever the things we are come across in, chahe hame kisi ko sujhav dena ho, hamare किसी को निमंत्रण देना हो, किसी को बधाई देनी हो, किसी को कोई सजेशंस देना हो, कुछ एडवाइस करनी हो, या हमारे पेरेंट्स से हमें कुछ परमिशन चाहिए हमें, या हम कुछ परमिशन किसी को दे रहे हैं, या किसी कुछ दुखद घटना होती है और हम अपने कंडोलेंसेस एक्सप्रेस करते हैं, ग्रेवेंसेस एक्सप्रेस करते हैं, तो वी राइट दिस इनफॉर्मल लेटर. नाउ रिमेंबर चिल्ड्रन, When you are writing this letter, use simple language. आपकी भाषा बहुत ही सरल होनी चाहिए. And express emotions and opinions using proper words. Yes, use of emotions is very important. But for that, you have to choose the correct words. So let's see the format of the letter. The letter has sender's address with pin code, date, salutation, body of the letter, subscription, and your name. So your letter must have for these things, and the format should be followed strictly. But remember, everything should align on left margin. Now, sender's address, we write building name, chawl name, your road name or lane name, followed by the place of your living, with pin code and date. Date, the date on which you are writing the letter. The one thing you remember, children, don't write your address too long. Preferably stick to these 4 lines only. So after the address, you will write the salutation as my dear, dear or beloved. For your friends and for your younger sister, you can write, or younger brother, you can write their name also. Now after this, leave a line and start writing the body in 3 to 4 paragraphs. Once it ends, write the subscription on the left side, that is yours, and then your name, that is XYZ. Remember, don't write your name, you just put either XYZ or A dot B dot C. Now, how to write the body part. For the first paragraph, children, you can start this with, how are you? I hope that you are all fit and fine. Or, how's your family getting on? You may write, there was no letter from your side. Hope everything is fine. Or, you may start, how's the weather at your place? Or, did your exams over? How was your picnic experience? Or you can say, the reason I am writing this letter. So you can begin with any of this type of sentences. Add one more line. So your first paragraph should have 2 to 3 sentences. Don't go much in more detail. Now the second paragraph should be about the topic of the letter given in the question. So you just need to elaborate that topic. Now, how you close the paragraph? There is a third paragraph. I will write again soon. Or do reply fast. Please give my regards to. Or take care of yourself. Hope to hear from you soon. Or you can simply say bye and goodbye. But bye and goodbye, just don't write. First, take 1 or 2 paragraph. And then at the end, you can write 1 or 2 line. And you can write bye and goodbye. My warm regards to your, then whatever you want to write. Hoping to meet you personally. I hope you will consider my advice. Take care. I hope you will reply to me soon. Bye for now. And, or you can write, that is all for now. So children, you can use any of these queries, or even other than these also. This is just for your practice I have given. There are certain phrases which express happiness, sorrow, and apology. So you can express your happiness, I received your letter on, and, or I'm happy to receive your letter. Thank you for your letter which I received. I'm so glad to hear. I'm very happy to learn now. So when you want to write something, your feelings should be expressed by using the proper phrases. Or to express the sorry, you say, I would like to say sorry for, and you can write the reason. Or I'm sorry for not writing or not replying. And you may come with this, I'm very sorry to hear or saddened with the news. This is especially for condolences or for this we are writing, expressing the feelings to a person who has lost something. Okay, children, when you are writing to your parents or grandparents, the salutation must have your loving daughter or son, or your affectionate. So, use this three, any of this proper salutation. But if you are writing to your friends or relatives, you can write your friend, your sincerely, your faithfully, or your loving niece or your loving nephew. Okay. Now, let's see one example of invitation letter. Look at here, how the address is written in the 3-4 lines. So, Navyug apartment with the flat number, Pritampura, Delhi, with, you can see here, pin code number and the date on which it is written. Now, dear Rudra, it's been a while since I have heard from you. Where have you been? I hope this letter find you in the best of your health. So you can see the body of the first, in the body, the first paragraph, it hardly has 3 sentences. So just don't write too much in the first paragraph of the body. Then second paragraph, as I said, it will be as per the topic given. So as summers are approaching, I was thinking if we could spend the summer break together at my place in Mumbai. I will introduce you to all my friends and close relatives. I will give you a city tour as well. We will spend some quality time in the afternoon near the seashore. To add cherry on the cake, the weather here is very pleasant during those days due to sea winds. And the third is, I am excited even at the thought of you and I spending the summer together after so long. I have to tell you a lot of things and expect the same from you. Give my regards to your auntie and uncle. Hope to see you soon. Your lovingly, and here they wrote name, but you will write A.V.C. So this is an example, children. The next is, many times in the 9th and the 10th standard, they give the sender's name also, the writer's address also. So here you are Priya, means the writer is Priya, a resident of 52A, DDA flat, Prith Vihar, New Delhi. You have learned that your cousin has been regularly missing his classes. Write a letter to your brother telling him about the importance of attending the classes regularly. So here you are advising them, you are giving suggestions. So here children, don't write your address. Address should be resident of 52A DDA flats. So look at here, what is the writer address is given? 52A, DDA flats, Prith Vihar, New Delhi, with the pin code number. Now, then the date in a proper format, leave a line and dear. Now here it is, cousin is written, so you can write your any name. Okay. Now, again, body in the three letter. I received a letter from your mother yesterday and was saddened to know that you are not doing well in your new school. Now, again the topic, what do you want to advise? So, your class teacher had reported to your parents that you have become a part of a group of rowdy students. I have been told that apart from scoring poorly in all the subjects, you have been constantly bunking classes. I have always known you to be a sincere and a hard-working student. Therefore, it goes without saying that I had never expected this from you. Your parents are extremely tensed about your performance. And the last one, I have assured them that given a chance, you would not let any one of us down. Keep your chin up and work hard. Let me know if you need any kind of help. And here, your loving sister and writer's name, because here it is mentioned you are Priya, so you need to write down the same name, Priya. Okay, children? So now coming to formal letter. This is for the business purpose, officials, authorities, to the government department, professional purpose, to the school authorities and other things. So here they are for the order letter or the letter of inquiry, letter of complaint, reply to a letter of complaint or a letter of application for leaving certificate, for bona fide or for asking leave. Remember, they are to be brief and to the point, and again, use simple language. So, the format of formal letter and informal letter is little bit different. Let's see that. The format. Sender's address with pin code, date. Now, name and address of the addressee to whom you are writing. The subject of your letter writing. If it is a reference, you need to give it. Salutation, body of the letter, subscription and your name. Sender's address as it is, same. Building name, road, lane, place, pin code and date. But children here will write to the ward officer, G South Ward, MCJ, Mumbai with pin code. So this is very important to whom you are writing. Now after writing this, again you need to write down the subject regarding what. It can be a complaint, it can be asking permission or it can be a reply. So you write down the subject that is given in your question. Now after this, it has to be respected sir and madam because it's a formal letter. So this line should be always there. Now after this, yes, body 3 to 4 paragraphs followed by subscription and your name. Again everything on the left margin. So now depending upon the question of your letter, you can start the first paragraph. If It is a reply with reference to your letter of 8 June and then you are replying. Or you can give your introduction, so and so person, and I am writing to inquire about. If you want to apply something or if you are ordering something, you can write after having seen your advertisement in and I would like to apply for the post or I would like to place the order. Or if you are making a complaint, you can write I am the resident of so and so things and wants to draw your attention on the following issues. जो भी कोई इश्यू आपके बारे में आप लिखना चाहते हैं और जो एग्जाम में दिया गया है. अगेन आई रिग्रेट टू ब्रिंग टू योर नोटिस, ये आप अपने कमिटी मेंबर्स को या किसी ऑफिशियल्स को या गवर्नमेंट सेक्टर्स के लिए स्टार्टिंग कर सकते हैं. या आई वुड लाइक टू ड्रॉ योर अटेंशन अबाउट द हीप ऑफ गार्बेज, अबाउट द लीकेज, अबाउट द गटर वर्क, अबाउट एनीथिंग. सो दिस विल बी ऑल्सो रिगार्डिंग द कंप्लेन. And if you want to apply anything for your in your school, you can write I am the student of your school, your name, you are studying in your which standard. And so the first paragraph, you can use any of these phrases depending upon the topic of the given question. Second paragraph, exactly elaborate the given topic of the letter. Now for the third paragraph, the last closing paragraph, you will say, please look into the matter and do the needful as early as possible. Or you may say, we wait your favorable reply. Or I would appreciate your immediate attention to this matter and hope our problem will get solved. Or you can say, please oblige and issue me my living certificate, my caste certificate, my bona fide certificate, or issue me whatever the documents you want. Please grant me, this is especially for the leave, please grant me the leave for days, whatever the reason you want to write. Or it's an earnest request to take necessary or immediate actions. And you may write, it is my sincere request to look into the matter. And so like this, you can start with your closing paragraph and then you add up the sentences. And of course, at last, while writing this formal letter, your subscription should have your faithfully, your truly, your sincerely, and yours obediently, and of course, X, Y, Z. So now, write a letter to the editor of a daily about the random cutting of a trees in your locality. So here you will write your address. If possible, write on the left side only, children. For me, it is not possible, so here I wrote it. Now, to the editor, the Times of India, DN Road, Mumbai, you can see the pin code. Then followed by the subject. Now here it is. Subject is given about the random cutting of trees. So the same thing you should write down, right? Now, respected sir, with due respect, I am to state that through your esteemed daily, I wish to inform the concerned authorities that there has been a rapid increase in cutting of trees in the vicinity of the RA colony in Goregaon. Now you can see the second paragraph. It will be about, you need to, about the importance of this tree. So you are going to elaborate it, how the trees are useful. Again, 5 to 8 lines, not more than that. And now, on behalf of all the residents of this area, I request you to kindly take immediate action to restore the greenery of this region. So whatever is your demand, whatever the solution you have, this should be reflected over here. Again, thanking you, your sincerely, and XYZ. So this is one example of formal letter. More children? Write a complaint letter regarding irregular water supply in your locality or your village. So again, you will write your own address. Try to write in 4 lines only with the date, followed by to whom you are writing. Again, their address with pin code number. Subject, see, a complaint letter regarding irregular water supply. That much only should be written. Respected sir, you can see the 3 paragraphs here. We are totally 500 families. So here you can give the introduction because you are writing on behalf of the entire locality. So here you use the word we, right? So your introduction and little bit about your problem, then elaboration in the second paragraph, and last, we have already given many complaints to our local authority. They are always giving us empty promises and doing nothing. So all your grievances, your unhappiness, whatever you want to write, whatever you want to express, write down then, and at the end, yours thanking you and the salutation. So children, thank you so much, but all this writing skill need lots of practice. So please keep practicing, and yes, don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon. Thank you so much.